Brockhampton is a group that at this point needs no introduction. After a meteoric rise in 2017 and 2018, the self-proclaimed boy band has become a huge phenomenon in the hip-hop scene. Love them or hate them, Brockhampton is a fascinating group. I remember being a junior and senior in high school and watching Brockhampton blow up and being so inspired by kind of the do-it-yourself aesthetic and attitude that they had. Combine this very inspirational attitude with the fact that a lot of their music was so summery and nostalgic and inventive, they quickly became one of my favorite groups. And I think a lot of people had a similar experience. We were very into Brockhampton in the summer of 2018, and then things kind of changed. As I began to get older and explore more music, my interest in Brockhampton slowly began to fade. This, combined with what I see as a gradual decline in music quality and their seeming inability to not hang out with abusers, left me not super excited for a new Brockhampton project, at least not in the way that I was in high school, where every leak, every detail, every Instagram post was the most important thing to me in the world. But the thing is, when a group means that much to you at some point in your life, you're pretty much always going to be interested, at least on some level. And with this latest album, Roadrunner, Brockhampton took the longest break between producing an album since their mixtape All American Trash and Saturation 1, with almost a 2-year break between Ginger and this new project. That, along with the fact that this album added a bunch more features, seemed like it had a more focused concept compared to Ginger, made me very intrigued. So because of all these different factors, how much the group used to mean to me, the tumultuous couple of years they have had since Amir's departure, and this interesting new direction incorporating new artists and new ideas into their songs, I figured I just had to do a first reaction to this album. If you want a bit more context about me as a Brockhampton fan, here's my ranking of the albums that might help you understand kind of the mindset I'm in going into this project. However, at the same time, I'm really not expecting anything. I'm not thinking, oh, I want another Saturation 2, or oh, I hope it's different from this. I'm literally just here to listen to the songs and see what we get. I've heard the first two singles, BUZZCUT and Count On Me. I thought BUZZCUT was a really cool, explosive, and interesting song, and I thought Count On Me was pretty boring. I'm interested to see if listening to those in the context of the album changes my opinion, but yeah, let's just get right into it. Okay, so like I said, I've already heard BUZZCUT. I'm gonna listen to it again just for the sake of the album continuity. I'm interested to see if it goes into the second song, Chain On. Yeah, here we go with Brockhampton, Roadrunner, New Light, New Machine. Who let the dope boys out? All right, I'm hoping for a transition, but we'll see. Yeah, nice. So the next song is Go ahead, chain on, nigga. Tell them boys where you fifth string young Peggy Ringo. Slick with the ink, these melodies need to a lingo. I gotta say, it's no surprise at all, but JPEG Mafia just absolutely sliding on this beat. Used to get 50 views, now they need Peggy's momentum. Let's yep. Check the addendum. Switch the code on speaking prophecies like that's a raven. Ball headed with no stack, have proper placement. Some of you niggas don't look well, this Peggy make you hate him. Damn. This is how I make mine. Wake up every morning like it's do or die. No surprise, Seuss get jealous when you cut the ties. Living lives, land some strong at the finish. Wow, okay, I mean, we're halfway into this song and it's pretty much only JPEG Mafia, but I can't be mad with how good this verse is. We catch them cops on cam. I don't need 6 seconds. You remember Vine. It's nasty.
Nice.
We don't believe that white guards, they getting rattled on. Wait.
Is that Dom? He sounds so different.
The flippers in my blood to be a stack. Had to handle other business. Ain't no riddles. It's a fact. If you see me in my innards, try to see me on the CCTV. Couldn't scan them like the cereal. Was scratched off on the barrel of the.
Wow, nice. City on my shoulder, be a soldier now. Ooh, yep.
Wow. Okay, interesting. That might be my favorite song that I've heard from this album so far. I think that when people look back on the Saturation Trilogy, the things that they really want out of Brockhampton are, you know, these pretty big posse cuts, but just with super catchy choruses. And I think that was a little bit what was missing from Ginger, at least for me. In Ginger, there were, of course, posse cuts, super long songs that were like 5 minutes, but there just wouldn't really be that hook, like sticking it together for me, which left a lot of the songs feeling kind of meandering. Also, there were just kind of like weird flows and stuff on that album. I don't really know, but this one, like, so straightforward and so simple, but that actually works super well for me. Kevin, JPEG Mafia, and Dom, and then just this very simple chorus, it just works because it's just simple, you know? Speaking of simple, though, this next song, Count On Me, it's kind of like it's a little too simple for me. I don't think any of the rap verses here are standouts, and while the chorus is very catchy, at just 2.5 minutes, the song doesn't really go anywhere for me, so I'll give it a listen, but I'm not expecting my opinion to change so much on this one in the context of the album. It looks so different to me. It's like you barely even know me. You was missing for me. I swear I'm tired. It'll be okay, no matter what they say about us. It'll be okay. I mean, he put Ryan Beatty on a hook and it's a done deal for me. Like, I think this hook is so catchy. I really don't like the reverb effect on this. Yeah, I don't know, dude. I might like it even less now, to be honest. I think that just it being sandwiched between Chain On and Bankroll, which if Bankroll's the same as the leak from a couple years ago, it feels like a momentum killer to me. And I don't know, it kind of has that very skeletal feeling that Ginger had, which I just really didn't like. There's kind of like a lack of energy to it. Like, you've got this really catchy chorus, but the beat is just so like, and I don't really feel like anyone caught that beat except for on the chorus. Like, none of the verses are really that good. But I'm very excited because next up is Bankroll, which we've been waiting for forever. So yeah, let's just hit it. Sit on your function, laugh in a dungeon. Don't know why you cuffing. What the? Okay, yeah, wait, I'm going back. That intro caught me off guard, but that was sick. Yup. Nice. Merlin and Matt on that hook, man. Whew, carrying that momentum. That sounds awesome. This beat is so good. Wow. That map part is just amazing. I love how loud that kick is. Oh! Wow, okay, well, I can hear the transition with that phone call, but Bankroll, very interesting. The last, like, half of that song, it just kept carrying the momentum and building and building. It's really weird so far how every song only has like one or two of the Brockhampton members on it. And the features obviously fill it out, but I don't know, you look back at like Saturation 2 with Gummy or something on the first song, like you've got everyone making an appearance. So this is really interesting. In between the clouds. Still love that sunshine. Whoa. When I look at myself, I see a broken man. Oh! Whoa, what? No way we're about to do this. Wow, that was unexpected. What a turn from Bankroll. What the heck? When I look at myself, I see a broken man. Remnants of my pops, put the Glock to his head. Nothing ever go as planned. The floral haven. Hope it was painless. I see you in the face. Wow, holy reflections off of there. I can't stand myself beside myself. I see you there. I know you care. Felt numb since September when I heard the image of a bloody backdrop. Fragments in the ceiling, felt your presence in the room, heard my mother squealing. Master of disguises, ash to ash, dust to dust, voids behind my eyelids, blacking out, bleeding out, silence, louder than a twisted tongue line. Wow. Whoa. Okay, I feel bad for like bobbing my head. This is pretty insane. Okay, so Joba, I guess, talking about his dad, who sounds like committed suicide. Wow, I don't know if I can add anything to this, but I think the instrumentation is like beautiful. Wait, oh my god, I'm so confused by the direction of this. Really, I mean, clearly very like emotional song, but I think this instrumentation switch is like, it's so intense, but it's working so well. Like, for the record, I can fly around the world absorbing light. Wow, dude. Ain't no love in this game, my this is not tennis. Take your shoes off, we just did the carpet set. Thank God I made it. Thank God I seen God last summer. I was niggas out here juggling, losing jobs, we're losing God, and everything is up. Wow, this is sick. Wow, dude, that was amazing. I kind of wish that was the opening to the album, but oh man, we've just taken a whole new direction. Wow. I think the instrumentation was the highlight for me, aside from Joba's verse. That was pretty amazing. That it was so angry, but like triumphant. And also, I mean, not to take anything away from Kevin's verse. I love that. But yeah, wow. Oh, that's so exciting. Okay. I'll be honest, the first four songs, definitely cool, but felt Brockhampton, right? Like this, The Light, makes me feel like excited for new, like where are we going from here? That's so cool. Next up is the longest song on here, 6 minutes and 11 seconds. We've got Windows featuring So Gone, So Flexy. Feels good to get this shit out the mud, nigga, made it from hard times, still love for the slums, nigga. So I think this is one of the first like signees to Video Store or something. So Gone, So Flexy, but dude sounds so much like Freddie Gibbs. Less than a dub, nigga. And how I feel to be a dub, nigga. I'm trying to be a better man, but none less yes. than a thug, nigga. Yes. Okay, this feels so classic to me. Classic in terms of like Brockhampton. Like this feels like a Saturation 1 song. I got a charge, now I'm back out. I bet this carbon blow it back out. Getting money, that's money. A fact now. Wow. Bitches, they don't know how to act now. Don't pour them up a light, but the floor not nice. So watch for your wife. I might take her out your life. You know, she wet my white tea. Now it's like a wet white. Yo. Respect my tribe. I'm a dog like Fife. Even oh, wait. I'm a dog like Fife. This was a Instagram leak like a little while ago. Wow, I'm so glad we got it. This sounds awesome so far. Okay, I mean, honestly, if this is gonna be the 6 minute song, I'm strapping in. Go Merlin. Peasantry. I don't even like sleep. Time is the only luxury. Fuck you to your owl. I'ma ship it laminated. Yes. Okay. Alright. Now I'm in it. I don't know if you could tell, but the energy was down a little bit. I was nervous, but bro, The Light and Windows, this is why I liked Brockhampton in the freaking first place. It's so creative. Like The Light being basically a rock song into Windows, we're doing this classic, classic hip hop. But listen to how with each verse, we've got the sax in the first verse, Matt's coming in, we have this guitar in the background. There's such a development and we're a minute and 26 seconds in. This is how Saturation like 3 felt to me, where it was just ideas. Oh my god, I've stopped this already twice, but like yes. It's me by reinflexing. I can see through your bullshit, yeah. Like your face was made of plex like I wanted me. Oh, this delivery. Baby, is the one inside the buggy man. You, I'm the boogie man. You never sleep again. Nightmares is like the yes. Ready to isolate. Light it up. We bring the light show. Who the hell invited all their friends? Yeah. Fucking fine. Yo! Oh my god. Window. Yo. Wow. This beat sounds amazing. Oh my god. Okay, I'm not overreacting, right? This is so good. The deliveries. Okay, this is another thing. My problem with Ginger, Kevin, every song uses freaking, I don't want to do a song. I just wanted to talk. Bruh, do you hear the deliveries on this? Everyone sounds so hungry. This chorus is sick. I can see the eye upon me when I close mine. Drug-induced comatose is leaking. Fuck police and authority. Never means nothing. Mind fucking myself to sleep. Had yep. to take it to the streets. Capitalistic group like all society. I'm so coming for you. Stay don't love you. Oh my god. Yo, is this one of the best Brockhampton songs, like, ever? This is insanely good. Just feel me up in the front door. I bless the beat with smoke and rain, ash like Mordor. The warlords come and check the land for the slaughter. The envy so green it should be flying a saucer. Alright, I'm genuinely blown away by that. Bro, why didn't this album start with The Light and Window? Like, I'm feeling like I'm gonna love the rest of this. I can't believe how good that song was. Okay. Alright, I mean, shove it up a tweet, tweet, tweet. Once I hear that, like, let's go. Yo, this sounds so good. Yes. Oh. Okay, this is exactly what I was talking about with You Can Count On Me, or Just Count On Me. If you're gonna do this type of song with the pop chorus and whatever, do you hear how much is going on? So many members are involved, there's so many harmonies, there's little switch-ups and detours, the cool little cha-cha in the beat. Like, this is literally just the more expanded version of Count On Me. This is so good. Oh, I'm becoming a stan again. So nice. That's so nice. We all know that sound effect. Charlie. Nice. Yes. Okay, I don't know what it is about the second half of this album, but it feels like the Brockhampton energy is there. I mean, I know the obvious comparison would be to Bleach, but for real, like, the beats cutting out and the layered vocals and people jumping in for two lines here and there, like, it really feels like we're back with so much effort. Nice. Wow, that's pretty. Yes. Dude, this is making me so nostalgic. Like, this isn't really, like, the type of music that I listen to too much anymore, but, like, I don't know, just that, like, group of friends making a song energy, like, that attracted me to Brockhampton back in the day. Like, I don't know, I'm getting it these last, like, few songs. Wow. Rips in the threads of the net I fell through. What I gained through. Yes. Wow. Pieces, all add up to nothing lately. Swim with it. What's the occasion? Dude, come on. I know my switch, I could hope this city. I gotta stop or I never will, and I just need to say, is it me or is Joba carrying this right now? That was a great classic feeling song. Joba's verse, so fun, reminded me of Sweet. And then this, the rock influence again, like The Light. Dude, this, since The Light, this album has picked up like so much. I'm like rattled. I know it's easy to just skip it, flipping out and you go. Maybe I wouldn't be so tasty when you say it. All my days are praying.
colors blinding. Fuck away from me. What's the occasion? Can we get much higher? So high. Come on. This is awesome, bro.
Banger. I literally feel like I'm struggling to put into words because this is like so unexpected. Usually with Brockhampton albums, because I was so into it, I was like very, I don't know, I could expect what's coming. And this has been just so like off the wall and fun. And I mean, I'm sure that that was like probably a darker song that I'm giving it credit for, but just that huge explosion at the end. Wow, I'm loving this. Okay, next is When I Ball. My mama said I didn't come into this world with tears. Instead, I welcome how I... Do you... Oh, God. Became the glue to a few things that couldn't be repaired. We saw a future in each other. Come on. The weight that she would need to bear. While Shark was going on vacation for a couple years. When they came back, they needed clothes. Wow. Souvenirs. I pick up my mama's home. I'm following her expressions. This is gorgeous, man. Come on. She had to mention. I nodded, she held me and wished I would be protected.
Dude.
Oh, come on. Okay, I won't lie, I did get slightly spoiled. Not really, but one of my roommates said there was a song that straight up felt like it could be on College Dropout, and this is it. This is gorgeous. Also, I know that there's Kevin's rumors that the last two Brockhampton albums are coming out this year, and this is the type of song that makes me feel like I'm fine with that, you know? Like, I hear something like this, and I'm like, this is a send-off. Like, wow, I love this. On my sucker free shit, since I was a fetus. Pulling up at the dock in a Mazda 626. And my dad was tripping bad, hit the gas like context. This was still one tragedy. Gritting the teeth down to the root, pain like a cavity. Forever. Oh man. Okay, that was beautiful. The production was amazing. Ah, oh, that hook. You always used to tell me I could be anything I wanna be. Oh man, literally made me feel like I was, you know, 18, graduating high school again. All right, we are now entering the last few tracks of the album. We've got track 11, Don't Shoot Up the Party. Niggas think I think these thoughts on purpose, but I knew about his sink foe, cash could rule me. Whoa. Colonized minds by masters and slaves. They both hate niggas and like niggas the same. But now tune in, baby, to the new classic. New machine, keep the peace, keep them dancing. Don't shoot up the party. Whoa. Don't shoot up the party. Please, please don't shoot. This is jam for your wins and your woes. For the people in the back standing on their tippy toes. On the prowl like a lion in a storm. Watching for the prey that might slit his throat. Kiss my ass, chew my balls like it's mistletoe. Fuck that, get cash by the truckload. There's a lot going on here, and I'm sure I'm missing stuff. But wow, production and energy. That Kevin verse was dope. Chicago, stay down, sorry. Stay down, you're ugly. Fuck you, come fuck me. I know. Don't shoot up the body. Wow. Wow, what a wild song. Yes.
Please, Lord.
Come on.
He needs you more, Lord. So when your love shines through like the light, let him know you want him to fight. He'll show into the light.
Wow.
Hold it in your life.
Oh my.
Oh. Love shines through like the light. Let him know you want him to fight. Waiting by your side.
I knew it, yeah.
Wow. He just needs to love in your life.
Last track. Here we go.
The light is worth the wait. I promise. Wait, why did you do it? The light is worth the wait. Sick of these niggas giving me false info. Like I ain't grow up on MTV, Boondocks, and the Chappelle Show. Bitch, I can handle the truth. That's how I entered. Never sold my soul. Should have protected all my paintings. To see the world move without you feel like a daydream. Kool-Aid stands. Couldn't save me from the world back then. Had Jeezy on repeat and your whip. No peace in my streets. And these days, no license. Only take to be to see the light, see the light, see the light. On my niggas to the right, right, right. You see the light, 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 light. When that hammer pulled back, did you think of me? You were the one that taught me how to be. Look at me now in all my glory. Overcame a lot, that's a different story. What happens when you die? Does it fade black? I sense you in my skin and the trucker cap. Miss it when we laugh. Didn't trust my intuition when I saw the cracks. I'm sorry, all I ever want to do is make you proud.
Jesus.
Set aside the pain as a use. I could use you because I'm scared as fuck. Tuck me in, always young enough to feel loved. To tell the truth, I am just like you. Left it all in the pistol that you used. Always be a little man.
Jesus.
Following your foot. The light is worth the wait. I promise. Wait, why did you do it?
Wow. What an interesting album. The reason I say that is because I think Kevin said it was a concept album, and I think the most clear concepts were, you know, the light, Joba's dad's story. I think it's kind of like a suicide thing, like the light at the end of the tunnel is worth the wait. You know, living is worth it. But it's also kind of confusing because it was so, like, fun to get there, if that makes sense. There were so many upbeat and fun and exciting songs, and then right after you have Don't Shoot Up the Party and, you know, The Light. For me, I think it was very clear. Songs 5 to 13 are, like, really fantastic. 1 to 4 are, like, fine, but I think that the album's identity really shows itself. Tracks 5 to 13 and 1 to 4 feel like they could have been on Ginger or something else, so I don't know. It's interesting. I will say, though, my biggest takeaway from this is that it feels like the creativity and the hunger is back, and I think this break was good. I think this album is much more focused, and even if it's not focused in like the story, like I was saying, the story kind of jumps around and whatever, it feels like there's intention, like a lot of intention in these songs to keep them exciting and keep them buried. And I feel like that was missing, at least from Ginger, for me. So I'm so excited by this project. Also, I think a lot of the features really enhance and fill out kind of the sound. I think the thing is, when you've got a group with 5 or 6 albums under their belt, even though there are a lot of them, you do kind of start to just get used to the voices that you hear. And this one, it was kind of like, you know, who's even doing this? Who's jumping in? Felt like there's just a bunch of people in a room making a song, and that was really cool. I'm interested to hear what fans think, because this has gotten a really good reception so far, and I can see why. I think this is great. Let me know what you guys thought in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching, and I gotta say, after this, I'm now really looking forward to what Brockhampton has to offer next. So yeah, thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Peace.